Alright, Shalom Yahshirala, back at it again with another lesson through the spirit and the power of Yahweh Bahashem Yahushai, Bahashem HaKodash. Before I begin this lesson, I want to give all honor, glory, and praises to our Heavenly Father and to His only begotten Son, Yahweh Bahashem Yahushai, Bahashem HaKodash. Next up, double honors to our apostles and our elders of Great Millstone, who still go out there to the highways and byways and feed us with 100% truth according to the Bible and rule well in peace, blessings, and safety, and mercy, and salutations to the Yakims out there who is pushing this truth in the four corners of the earth, man. With boldness, righteousness, and sincerity to the best of their abilities, where God, if our people here, what do they forbear in the names of Yahweh Bahashem Yahushai? And I'm back at it again with another lesson through the spirit of how Yahweh Bahashem Yahushai, Bahashem HaKodash. The name of this lesson is going to be called Blessed Our Day That Seek the Lord, man. You know, blessed our day, man, that seek the Lord. You know, why he may be found through the Spirit. So without further ado, we're going to jump right into the scriptures. We're going to start off with the book of Psalms. The book of Psalms was the 105. Psalms 105 verse 3. Glory ye in his holy name. Exactly. That shows that this name is important, man. When you go back to that word holy, go back to the Hebrew word kodash, which means separate, man. So this separate holy name that has to be given to you by the Lord, we're supposed to glorify in it, man. We glorify it by praying. We glorify when we go out down the highways and hedges. We go out there, we glorify the name. When we make these YouTube videos through the Spirit of Yahweh Bahashem Yahushai, we always exalt that holy name, and only the elect of the nation of Israel is going to be glorified that name unto the end, you know. And it reads on, let the heart, which the word heart, go back to the Hebrew word law, which meaning your mind, let the mind, it's like him, let the mind of them, the elect, once again, rejoice that seek the Lord. Exactly, man. They're going to rejoice that they was able to find the Lord, that they was able to find the truth, man, you know. That's why, matter of fact, let me get that quick precept since it came into my mind. Let me get this right quick, then I'm going to go right back into the lesson. This is the book of Romans. So I can bury me for one moment. This is the book of Romans, chapter 11, verse 7. And it reads, what then? Israel, which is a people before us, a place, is talking about your so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native American Indians, and you Israelite foreigners, according to the seed of your fathers. What then? Israel had not obtained that which he seeketh for. And what is our people seeking for? They're seeking or hunting down for the truth, man. You know, they're looking for the truth in all the wrong places, though, man. You know, the truth could be right there in front of them, and they can't see it because they was blinded by the Lord. And it reads, but the election, which is the chosen, the chosen ones to get the chosen ones who are able to get the knowledge, you know, but the election have obtained it. Why? Because Yahweh Bahashem Yahushai, who the world ignorantly calls God and Jesus Christ, gave him the truth, man. And you know what I'm saying, and guided them to the men that he set up to teach his word to get the proper breakdown of the scriptures. And it reads, but the rest. Were blinded, exactly, and the rest was blinded. The rest of the what? The Israelites. The two-thirds was blinded from getting this truth, man. You know? So now that they're blinded by the Lord, man, they're going to be destroyed by the Lord, man. So back in Psalms 105, verse 3, glory ye in his holy name, which is Yahweh, which meaning he is, and Yahweh Shai, which meaning he saves and he delivers, man. You know? Supposed to glorify their name day in and day out. Through the Spirit of Yahweh Bahashem Yahushai. Glory ye in his holy name. Let the heart of them that rejoice. Let the heart of them rejoice that seek the Lord. Exactly. Seek the Lord while he may be found, man. You know? And I can say through the Spirit of Yahweh Bahashem Yahushai, and I can also speak for the other brothers, you know, that we're glad that we was able to get this truth, man, while it was still time to get it. While the doors of repentance were still open unto us, man. You know? We're rejoicing. We're happy that we was able to get this truth, man. Why? Because it's keeping us in a stable mindset, man. It gives us hope, you know? And it gives us a power through the word. So this is the book of, this word is the comforter. This word is the one that strengthens us. This is the book of Isaiah 55, verse 6. Seek ye the Lord while he may be found. Exactly. And blessed are they that seek the Lord while he may be found, because the Lord is going to take his men off of the internet, and the Lord is going to take his men off of the streets, man, of teaching his word. You know, it says, seek ye the Lord while he may be found, right? Because Amos 8 and 11 is going to be in effect very, very soon, man, of the family of the word, man. Call ye upon him while he is near. How are you going to call upon the Lord, man? First and foremost, you have to be taught through the men that he said to teach his word, which is are the apostles, the elder apostles, and the elders of great millstone, man. You know, down the younger brothers like us that received this truth, man. You know, you had to be taught the names of the Lord in order for you to call on the name of the Lord, man. And ultimately, Yahweh Shema Shah has to be dealing with you in order for you to receive the name from the men of the Lord, man. You know, so back in Isaiah 55, verse 6, one more time. Seek ye the Lord, seek ye the Lord while he may be found. Call ye upon him while he is near. Exactly, man. And you call upon the Lord while he is near, you know, through the men that he set up. And then once you learn the names, and get the name by the Spirit of the Lord, then you're able to call upon him, man. You know. So now we're gonna go to the book of Amos. This is the book of Amos. Let me see. This is the book of Amos 5 and 4. For thus saith the Lord unto the house of Israel, which is the people of before it's a place. Once again, it's talking about you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native American Indians, and you Israelite foreigners, according to the seed of your fathers. Seek ye me, and ye shall live. Exactly, man. How do you seek the Lord? You seek the Lord, once again, through the prophets that he set up to teach his word, man. Once again, those prophets are starting off with the apostles and the elders of great millstone down in the younger brothers like us, man. You know, whom Yahweh Shema Shah gave the 100% truth according to the Bible to, man. You know, and it says, and ye shall live. Exactly. You're going to be a living soul again, man. You know, you're going to get that breath of life, which is the understanding of these scriptures, man. You know, because Proverbs 4 and 7 says, matter of fact, let me get it. And blessed are they that are able to receive this saying, and blessed are they which is able to seek the Lord while it may be found. So this is the book of Proverbs, chapter 4, verse 7. Wisdom is the principal thing. Exactly. Wisdom of what? The wisdom of this Bible, man. The understanding of it is the principal thing. When we look at that word principal, meaning the most important, man. You know, it's the most important thing to do in these last days, man. It's to get the wisdom and knowledge and understanding of the Bible while you still can. As much as you can. And it reads, Proverbs 4 and 7, wisdom is the principal thing. Therefore, get wisdom, right, while it may be found. And with all thy getting, get understanding. Exactly. With all thy getting, you're getting the wisdom, you're getting the knowledge. Top that all off, you have to get the understanding of the scriptures, man. You know? And then you'll be able to become a living soul again. You know, and teach the right doctrine according to the Bible, man. You know, and blessed are they that are able to do so. So now we're going to go to the book of Isaiah. You know, this is another quick lesson through the Spirit by Yahweh Shema Shah by Shema Kakodash. This is the book of Isaiah, chapter 34, verse 16. Seek ye out of the book of the Lord and read. Exactly. It says, seek ye out of the book of the Lord. What's the book of the Lord? The 1611 King James Holy Bible, man. You know, that's the book of the Lord. That's the book Yahweh Shema Shah gave the inspiration to through men to write this word, man. You know, for all learning today. And it reads, seek ye out of the book of the Lord and read. And that word read means to understand or to comprehend. You know, so seek ye out of the book or out of this Bible and understand what the Bible is telling you, man. And it reads on, no one of these shall fail. Exactly. No one of these of what? The prophecies, man. None of the prophecies that Yahweh Shema Shah said that was going to happen are going to fail, man. Because once the Lord have spoken it, it's going to come to pass, man. For an example, didn't the Lord say that we was going to go into slavery and we was going to be servants to our enemies if we didn't obey and if we didn't hearken to the words of Yahweh Shema Shah? Didn't it come to pass? You know? So what makes you think that this is not going to come to pass, man? You know, what makes you think that the prophecies of the Lord that he set up is going to fail, man? You know? And it reads, none shall want her mate. Exactly, which means you can't mate any book with this Bible, man. This Bible stands alone. This Bible is the supreme, man. You know, this Bible is the top notch, the non-GMO, so to speak, man. You know, it's the real deal, Holyfield. And it reads, for my mouth it had commanded it, and his spirit, it have gathered them. Gathered who? The elect of the nation of Israel, which we're hoping to be, man. The spirit, which is the knowledge and wisdom and understanding of this Bible, have guided the elect, man. You know, and then once they get the wisdom and knowledge and understanding of the scriptures, what they're going to do, they're going to get more brothers. They're going to get more fruit through the spirit of Paya Haba Shimei Arashai, man. You know, that's what this ministry is all about. This is all about the elect, the chosen, the remnant, man. You know, for the 2/3 of our people are going to be destroyed, man. You know, so they're not important, man. You know, so this is the book of Matthew 6:34. And it says, but seek ye first the kingdom of the Most High. Exactly. This is Lord Yahweh Shah speaking, who the word ignorantly calls Jesus Christ. It says, but seek ye first the kingdom of Yahweh Shemal Shah, which is what? It starts off with this knowledge. You know what I'm saying? In order for you to be the first fruits of the kingdom of heaven, you have to be the elect. And the elect is going to do what? Get the 100% truth, wisdom, and knowledge, and understanding according to the Bible. So it's this knowledge, man. You know, but seek ye first the knowledge of the scriptures, you know, which is the kingdom of the Most High, and his righteousness, and all these things shall he add, be added unto you. Exactly, all what things, man? The all heart's desires, man. You know, the women, the spiritual powers, you know, salvation. You know, anything that brother's heart desires, man. You know, seeing Yahweh Shai, seeing the angels. You know, ruling the planets. You know, establishing righteousness on the earth, man. You know, it's going to be added unto the elect of the nation of Israel, which we're hoping to be. Because why? They first and foremost fear Yahweh Shemal Shai, and they seeked him out while he was made, while he was able to be found, man. You know. And then seek ye first the kingdom of the Most High, which is this knowledge, which is this truth, man. And then all these things should be added unto you. So the most important thing, the principal thing right now, is to get the wisdom and knowledge and understanding of the scriptures as much as we can, while we can, you know. And blessed are they that are able to receive this truth, man. So hey, with that, Lord, with this video is edifying for Yakims that are just watching, to the Yakims that's listening and receiving the word, you know, in sincerity and in truth. Before I close out, I want to give all honor and glory and praises to our Heavenly Father and to His only begotten Son, Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahushah, Bahashem, Achakwadash. Next up, double honors to our apostles and our elders of Great Millstone. Peace, blessings, and safety and mercy to the Akims out there who is pushing this truth in the four corners of the earth. With that, until next time, I say, Shalom, Shalom, Kwam Yashirala, Shabbat Chayyar.